We've all seen the photos. We've all grown familiar with the bathtub ring that seems to get more apparent year after year. And of course, we've all seen the crazy news stories about the water levels dropping and revealing what actually lied below the surface of the lake. Sitting at about 27% full, Lake Mead has fallen approximately 170 feet since the year 2000. It's obvious that the Southwest United States is in a drought. Yes, we have a water shortage, but can Las Vegas really run out of water? The answer to that question is complicated, but if we all conserve, we don't necessarily have to. A real and looming concern is if Lake Mead water levels were to fall to 895 feet, or Deadpool. Deadpool is when the water will no longer be able to flow over the dam. The dam would no longer produce power or release water to the approximately 25 million people living downstream from Hoover Dam that rely on Lake Mead as a water source. This would catastrophically affect regions downstream such as Los Angeles, Phoenix, San Diego, Tucson, and Mexico. This situation would be disastrous for all people living in those regions, but especially for farmers. If this were to happen, Las Vegas would lose a power source, but the city would still have water. Las Vegas would still be able to draw water from the lake through the third intake and the low-level pumping station. Construction on this pumping station was completed in 2020 and started operating in 2022. Together with intake number 3, the pumping station and deep water intake ensure Las Vegas has access to its primary water supply, even if the lake does reach Deadpool. The investment has already paid off as Lake Mead intake number 1 is now above the lake's surface. With the third intake in operation, the Southern Nevada Water Authority General Manager called Las Vegas, quote, the most water-secure municipal area in the Colorado River Basin. Some good news is the Federal Bureau of Reclamation is evaluating strategies to further reduce water demands on Lake Mead to help prevent the water level from falling to Deadpool. More good news is that Las Vegas is one of the most water-efficient cities in the world. Any water that goes down the drain in the Las Vegas Valley gets treated and returned back to Lake Mead. A common misconception is that people need to stop moving here or we need to stop building hotels. We hear this often from people, but it's not necessarily a problem. Over the years, as a valley, we have become so much more water efficient that even with a population gain of more than 750,000 people since 2002, the Las Vegas area has actually managed to cut its water usage by more than 30% in that same time. Las Vegas is a trailblazer when it comes to water conservation, which is great. But the state of Nevada is only allocated 4% of the total water allotment between the lower Colorado River Basin states, which are Nevada, California, and Arizona. California gets 58.7% and Arizona gets 37.3%. So Nevada's 4% is quite literally a drop in the Lake Mead bucket. There's no sugarcoating it. The drought and water shortage are real, and the situation is very serious. To reverse the crisis, action to use less water is ultimately going to be required by all states drawing water from the Colorado River, not just Southern Nevada. And it requires every sector of water users to conserve, from agriculture to urban areas. For more on conservation efforts in Southern Nevada, check out our video, What's Inside a Wastewater Treatment Plant, where we go on a walkthrough tour of the City of Las Vegas's wastewater treatment facility.